What is up, everyone? So I made a privacy-focused browser extension that basically could be one of the best privacy-focused extensions that have ever existed. I'm totally kidding. It's a super simple extension, but I do hope that you get a lot of use out of it. We'll get more into that in a little bit, but for now, most people don't actually realize the extent of how bad they're tracked every time they go online, whenever they open their browser. Like every site that they actually visit, every search that they type in, every video that they click, it all gets logged and profiled and monetized. And, you know, not just by the websites themselves, but by the entire hidden industry that exists around it that treats your life like raw data to be mined. And over time, this kind of constant surveillance becomes invisible. It becomes normal to people, and people stop doing things like noticing. But there's still a ton of privacy violations that happen every second that we're online. But normal doesn't really mean acceptable, and that's where privacy front ends actually come in. If you haven't actually heard of them, they're basically mirrors or pass-throughs of major websites like YouTube or Twitter or Reddit and all the others that exist, but without the trackers that come with them, without the fingerprinting, and without the stupid forced logins that exist. The endless advertising is also gone. They strip down the experience to just the content, and many actually even do it anonymously. So it means there's no JavaScript, you know, nightmares to worry about, and you know, the corporate surveillance is pretty much gone, which is awesome, which just means that it's you and the information that you actually asked for. So one thing I am curious about, though, is let me know in the comments if you have actually used privacy front ends. And if so, which ones you think are the best, which ones you think suck, or if you didn't know what they were, that. I'd like to see the actual numbers that actually exist on the specific topic, if you're okay with sharing that information. Privacy front ends first started gaining real traction when people started to realize that there was basically no other way to use these platforms safely. Tools like Nvidius for YouTube, Knitter for Twitter, LibreReddit for Reddit gave users a way to interact without actually having to sell their souls every time they wanted to click on a link and see something. Over time, that movement just expanded. Now, there are front ends for almost everything, from Instagram, TikTok, Google Search, Medium, IMDb, and a ton more. Every one built by people who actually value your privacy more than your profit potential, basically. The problem is that manually switching to these front ends every time you click a link is a pain. It's fairly easy to say that you'll do it, but nobody really wants to have to rewrite all of the links that they click. So it's fairly easy to say that you're going to do it or that you care about your privacy. But you know, when the default web keeps bringing you back into these mainstream sites, eventually you just say screw it and give up and click through like everybody else, which is absolutely human nature. It's the system that exists that slowly grinds us down and just kind of gets us to give up, learned helplessness of sorts. And that's exactly why I built the Privacy Please extension. It's lightweight, it's free, and it's open source. It logs nothing and it doesn't report anything back whatsoever. It doesn't do that, you know, anonymously collected data usage. There's none of that crap. It just sits quietly in your browser and intercepts the trash links that you're about to click and silently redirects them to a privacy-respecting front end. So when you go and you open up, say, a YouTube link, you get an Nvidius instance instead. And when you open up Twitter or X, you get Knitter. When you hit Reddit, you get LibReddit. You know, Google Search redirects to Sears XNG, and Medium gets replaced with Scribe. And even Quora in this instance gets, and IMDb, I think. I think I got IMDb. I'll have to check on that one. Put in. But you don't actually have to memorize anything, which is the absolute upside. You don't have to install a dozen extensions, one for every site. You don't have to do any of that crap. And you don't have to trust a middleman. You just browse the way you always would, but without the parasites riding on your back. And the extension is completely free. It always will be. It's listed on both the Firefox add-in store and the Chrome web store. So, I mean, if you prefer to install it manually, or if you want to audit the code yourself, and please do, it's fully available on GitHub as well, on my GitHub. And there's no obfuscation or stupid hidden APIs. Like, privacy isn't something that you ask for. It's something that you take. And every day, you browse without it, for a lot of people that are out there. And you're feeding a system that was built to exploit you. Every day you choose tools like this, you get to punch that system back in the face just a little bit harder and keep a little bit of yourself to yourself. If you're serious about privacy, start, you know, tooling up and using tools that actually respect you. Start building habits that defend you, and start realizing that the biggest challenges don't actually come from asking permission for things, but rather they come from refusing to be prey. I would advise you to download Privacy Please, install it, and forget it's even there. Just don't forget to leave a review if you like it. I'm kidding, obviously. You're free to hop on and tell me you hate it and it sucks. But the frustration barrier for users to get privacy should be as low as possible, in my opinion. Invisible, if you know, possible. And I hope that this helps. And I hope that someone more qualified than me, with better skills and more time, forks it and improves it without adding a bunch of crap and tracking to it. And I hope that you enjoy it and get a use out of it, and that it helps you in your daily life. In any case, as always, guys, thank you for watching. And I really appreciate all the support on the channel. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.